I originally started digital art because I wanted an easy way to like design clothes. Because most of the time when I draw, it's usually more fashion oriented.
I always drew like Pokemon and that sort of thing, and that kind of just got me going. And I used to draw my own books as a kid and found that it was something I was passionate about.
My friends and I actually made like our own fake little comic book company when we were in fifth grade because we loved drawing and it was a fun way to express ourselves.
I like character design because I really like writing stories about the characters that I make and like how they would all interact with each other and how they fit into one world.
I began drawing and soon I realized that I was getting good at it, and I had never really been good at anything before, and I wanted to have something to pour my heart into and to focus my time on, to be able to say, I'm skilled at this. This is what makes me special.
The beauty of this program is that we start small, we start fun, and we move our way up through where students are eventually working with actual clients, working around the school, doing basically school to work programs.
The environment here is very different than a normal classroom.
We have the little like fairy lights and...
And it's just a more relaxed classroom.
Even though it's quiet in here, you can hear the little like clanking of pens and the giggling in the background.
You get a close-knit class of people all helping each other design.
When you first start, there's a lot more guidelines to help you kind of learn, but then as you get higher up, it kind of lets you go your own path.
We had to do like full vector drawing, which is, you know, it's art without any pixels. It's like one clean line that is achieved through like programs like Adobe Illustrator.
I use Clip Studio Paint because it's, to me, it's a really easy program to navigate.
I mainly used Procreate for the image that I created.
Pretty much use Adobe for everything, like Adobe Illustrator, Adobe Photoshop. For like video things, I'll do Premiere.
For this one, I used Adobe Fresco, which is more for like illustration than like logo design, which is what Adobe Illustrator is usually used for. But I did illustration with vectors, so.
This image I'm working on right now is Dante, who's an author I enjoy, and so I was hoping to use digital arts to showcase another passion of mine, which is just literature and philosophy and that sort of thing.
I kind of had the idea here of the marionette kind of being controlled by society and expected to act a certain way.
I started this piece last year. I used Google Translate for everything to put it in Ukrainian. And then like kind of on the blood splatter spilling down, it's like kind of death, mass graves, shelling, you know, kind of the stuff that was happening.
Sometimes I design a character first and then I write something about it. Sometimes I write something and then make a character about it. Two things that work really compatibly together. Art always has stories to it, and stories are always artful, I guess you could say.
This class has really helped me like figure out what to do behind the scenes when it comes to like the production side of things. In college, I want to major in graphic design, so it helped me figure out how it works in the real world.
I'm really thinking about doing digital arts, like specifically logos for companies, as a job.
One of my most award-winning designers, Jaden Allen, is currently a design student in program at Oregon State University, and he is currently running his side business, which is called Gilt PDX.
Gilt's my brand. It's a Portland-based streetwear company and art company where I sell all my prints, clothes, and designs. Ideally, I wanted to work for like a company like Nike, which I still think would be pretty cool, but I want to do a lot of freelance work too, because I'm starting to realize how that's more possible.
More than anything, I want to continue with the characters that I design and make them into something. I dream big, and I don't know how that's going to work out, but I hope I can expand on what I'm doing here in a professional setting.
Finding my passion through this was like really relieving, I would say, because every kid in high school is kind of like, what do I do in college? So finding out that like I like this and want to pursue it further was really like relieving, and it felt good, so I didn't have to stress about it anymore.
The creativity field is huge and ever-changing, and there's so many avenues. There's graphic design, animation, 3D modeling, filmmaking. There are so many branches, so many avenues to be successful in this one umbrella field. The theme of the starving artist is not even a thing anymore.
I love to spread the message that creation's for everyone. It doesn't matter how old or young you are, you should always be creating.
This is more interesting than sitting in an office for however long. This is like I'm actually doing something with my life, making something and putting it out into the world.